honest. Am I ugly, yes or no?
Women in black slacks with accentuating off-white pinstripes. Whoa, everything goes according to plan. I'm the new cancer, never look better, you can't stand it. Because you say so under your breath, to your reading lips. When did he get all comfortable? Haven't you heard that? I'm the new cancer, never look better, and you can't stand it.
You look lonely.
In honor of Pride Month, that I missed, here's a few reasons why I love being asexual.
Disclaimer, this is all my own personal experience, and it's mostly just for the meme. Okay.
Number one, the flag.
Stunning, adorable, look at this lovely mix of color.
Number two, the rings. We look bad as fuck. Number three, if you're upfront about being asexual, it's a great way to deter people who are just trying to get into your pants. Number four, having a third eye that allows you to see the difference between romantic and sexual attraction.
Not everyone has that.
Number five, not being horny on main. Number six, not making drunken mistakes. At least not of the sexual kind. I'm still a dumbass. Seven, people know you aren't objectifying them.
Respect women and drink water, you thirsty fuck.
Number eight, saving money. Sex sells, you say? Not to me. Try again, you capitalist pigs.
Me questioning my sexual orientation for the 97th time.
About to blow your mind real quick. You know it's gender fluid pride day today, right? But liquid it also is. International Asexuality Day, 6th of April. Let's celebrate all of our beautiful asexual people. We love you, you're valid.
What are you doing in my house? What are you doing in my house?
I want waffle fries.
One thing that will never cease being amusing to me is the fact that people on the ace spectrum, whether they're asexual, aromantic, demisexual, graysexual, you know, wherever they lie on that spectrum, tend to fall in one of three categories. Either they are some of the dirtiest minded people you've ever met in your life, completely oblivious when it comes to anything sex related, or a really strange combo of the two. And I've already had this theory for a while, but it was confirmed when the other night I was hanging out with two of my friends who were also on the ace spectrum, and we had a perfect example of each one of those categories. And if you're wondering, yes, I'm the strange combo. What a surprise.
It was never gonna be you. It was never gonna be you. So for you to be so delusional and crazy like that, it's ridiculous. It's real.
I will grow under any conditions.
I think I'm allergic to tap water.
More asexual microlabels.
So let's talk about cupiosexuals.
So cupiosexuals are people who do not experience sexual attraction, but do want and pursue sexual relationships. Now you might be saying, well, that's just sex favorable, but not all the time. Cupiosexual folks can be sex favorable, but they don't have to be. The label describes anyone on the asexual spectrum who does not experience sexual attraction, but does pursue sexual relationships with partners. The asexual spectrum is one of the best spectrums.
Bro, I made up my mind. I would never send for anyone again.
Oh yeah? Who's that over there?
That's an exception.
Sex mode activated. It's
fucking time.
Have you ever been in love?
I don't think so.
Do you want me to describe it to you?
Good girl in a straw hat with her arms out in a cornfield. That is a scarecrow.
Wow, that person is really pretty. Wait, is this sexual attraction? Is that what I'm experiencing right now? Wow, look at this bookshelf, so perfectly organized. I love it. I feel the same way about the person that I do this bookshelf, and I definitely don't want to fuck the bookshelf. Still ace. Yeah, still ace. Okay, we're good.
Fuck you!
Hey man, this look pretty good, man. Where your clothes at?
I am having, this is crazy, but I'm having feelings again. Like some kind of 14-year-old kid or something. I mean, you remember feelings, right?
Yeah, I have feelings every single day of my life.
Do you? Are you saying you don't have feelings?
Halloween falls in Asexual Awareness Week. I'm not saying Halloween is officially the ACES holiday, but yes, that is what I'm saying.
Good girl in a straw hat with her arms out in a cornfield. That is a scarecrow.
Good. Can you say Ace Rights? Of course. Ace Rights. Heck yeah.
Can you say Ace Rights, please?
Ace Rights.
What's happened? Everyone's spamming the asexual pride. Poggers.
Yeah,
because you ace. Said ace.
Does ace mean asexual?
Yeah.
Sometimes.
Awesome.
Yeah. Well, not in the phrasing I was meaning it, but it
No, but it can be.
We're on about cards. That's cool. I'll happily say that as a compliment.
Sure, Ace Rights.
I'm so happy! I'm so sad!
Uh-oh. Boner alert!
Someone asked me on my demisexual, demiromantic video if there was an opposite identity. The identity they were looking for was fraysexual or frayromantic. Let's talk about it. This is part 12 of Ace Ed. A fraysexual is someone who experiences sexual attraction to people they don't know well, but lose that attraction once they get to know them. The aromantic counterpart is frayromantic. So in this case, instead of exclusively experiencing secondary attraction like demis, frays exclusively experience primary attraction that fades. This is not the same as acoy sexual or acoy romantic, as it has nothing to do with the reciprocation of attraction from the other person. However, similarly to acoys, if they do decide to pursue romantic or sexual relationships, they will very likely not last very long. They might be more interested in QPRs. Remember, you can be fraysexual and not frayromantic, and vice versa.
I'm picking up real sketch vibes.
Makeup inspired by my pride flag.
Got the club going high on a Tuesday.
Touch me not, harlot, for I am unmoved by your physical ways.
So are you gonna come over and cuddle with me forever so I can talk to you about dragons or what?
Hello everyone, there are stickers on my wall. Since I talked about abrosexual in my last video, I figured it'd be good to do
the asexual spectrum, or aspec.
First up is apothecexual. Apothecexual is a person who is sex repulsed, which means they don't want sex for themselves or anyone else. Next is lethosexual. Lethosexual is also known as achiosexual. This is someone who may experience sexual attraction, but they don't want it reciprocated, which means that they don't want sex, even if they may have sexual attraction. Next is cupiosexual. Cupiosexuals are the opposite of lethosexuals. They don't experience sexual attraction, but they still want a sexual relationship. This is demisexual. Demisexuals are people who experience sexual attraction only after a platonic and or romantic relationship has been formed. And this is phrasexual, which is the opposite of demisexual. Sexual attraction fades after a platonic or romantic bond is formed. All of these sexualities also go the romantic way as well.
Oh my God, so handsome!